Last February 24, Russia invaded Ukraine. This was the main reason for the PSEI's 2.1% decline that day and the market's volatile performance recently. Consumer stocks are among the weakest as they will hurt the most from rising inflation caused by higher oil prices and wheat prices, which are among Russia and Ukraine's major exports. On the other hand, mining stocks are rising as prices of commodities, including coal, nickel, industrial metals, and gold, are increasing. However, if history were to be our guide, there is a strong likelihood that the stock market will be trading higher 6 to 12 months later, despite the ongoing volatility. This is based on the performance of both the US S&P 500 index and the PSEI index during five geopolitical events in the past, namely the Gulf War of 1990, the 9/11 terrorist attacks in 2001, the Iraq War of 2003, Russia's invasion of Georgia in 2008, and Russia's annexation of Crimea in 2014. Note that the S&P 500 and the PSEI both ended higher 3 out of 5 times, 6 and 12 months after the said events started. Also, during the 2 times when both the U.S. and the Philippine markets were down, there were other more significant factors in play. For example, during the time of the 9/11 terrorist attacks, the U.S. was in the middle of a bear market as the dot-com bubble burst. On the other hand, the Philippines was still in the process of recovering from the Asian financial crisis. Meanwhile, when Russia invaded Georgia in 2008, the world was in the middle of the global financial crisis. This was the main reason why the U.S. and the Philippine markets were weak and not the Russian invasion. In fact, it's not for the bear markets in 2001 and 2008. The U.S. and Philippine stock markets may have performed better 6 to 12 months later after geopolitical tensions escalated. The most likely reason why markets rebounded 6 months later is because oil price spikes were not sustained. For example, during all five geopolitical events that we highlighted, oil prices were lower 6 months after the event started. As such, inflation became a non-issue. Although the Russian-Ukraine crisis is partly responsible for the significant increase in oil and commodity prices this year, prices could also return to more reasonable levels by the second half of 2022 if history were to be our guide. This should address concerns that Russia's invasion of Ukraine could result to stagflation globally, as Russia accounts for around 10% of the world's oil production. Because the market usually trades higher 6 months and 12 months after geopolitical tensions arise, investors shouldn't be too worried despite volatile market conditions prevailing. In fact, it would be wise to buy stocks when they are sold off because of the Russian-Ukraine crisis.